Avraham made all his Baalei Tshuva by teaching them what's going to be their end in hell if they won't repent. That's it. Just one way. That's what the Zohar says. Nothing else. There is a God. He made the world. Everything you have, it's from him. There's no idols. None of that, it's legal. And if you continue to be idol worshippers, you will be burned in hell. That was the tactic of Avraham Avinu. You don't have to believe me. Go to the Zohar, Parashat Lech Lecha, and read over there. So basically, Avraham Avinu wouldn't be able to give one speech in America today. After they hear he speaks about hell, oh, no, no, you're too strict. Abraham, leave us alone. It's not for us, you know. We're liberal. We are modern Orthodox. We don't allow these kinds of things. Not only that, you have today chutzpah speakers, few of them, with a rotten ideology and agenda that dare to say in their lecture, there's no such thing hell. With such zilzul and chutzpah, there's no such thing hell. You know it's going to be a hell? That you're going to be next to someone that enjoy and you enjoy less. They make up their own Torah. Clowns. Clowns. They make up their own ideas and teach it like it's divine. Such criminals, Hashem Yirachem. You cannot believe it. They have an agenda. What's their agenda? They don't want to use fear. They cut it out of the Torah. They don't want to use the word fear. They don't want to use anything that scares people. Why? They decided they know better than Hashem what helps and what doesn't help. And what people should know and what they shouldn't know. So they right away eliminate half of the Torah. And when they hear somebody else say things that the Torah say, they begin to lie and say, there's no such thing. I don't believe them. They already know that 99% of the public never open a book. Everything they know is from a lecture. They never open a book. They can't go and check. They're going to open the Gemara and check themselves what the Gemara really says. Sometimes you see people that supposedly are in yeshivot, they argue about things and you know they never learn. The mamash never learned the Gemara. They argue without actually going to the Gemara and see what's written over there. Like if you remember a year ago with the tragedy in Pittsburgh, that I gave you an example that the Gemara in Masechet Sanhedrin, page Mem Zayin, 47 in the bottom, the Gemara says, who is going to heaven when he dies on Kiddush Hashem? The Gemara discuss over there someone that died in an unexpected death. Mita Meshuna, strange way to die. Fell from a building, got hit by a lion. Not unexpected death. Not someone who became old and is in bed and he dies. Or someone that had cancer for a year or two and everybody knew it's a matter of time. No. Any unexpected death, it's already it's not in the way of the nature. So the Gemara over there said that if a person died in a sudden death, and it's also a strange way to die, nothing expected or natural death, it gives him some kind of atonement. Ave lechapara, the Gemara said. That's all. Now comes hundreds of speakers all over the world, especially here in America, all kinds of liberals, and totally modify the Torah, and some of them lie on purpose. Some of them accidentally modify the Torah because they counted on someone else that they heard. But some of them know what's written, and they modify it on purpose. Why? To gain popularity and money. The more people like your lectures, and they're not intimidated by that, and they feel great, and they laugh, they release more checks. They don't like to give money to someone who told them you're going to end it up in hell. Usually it doesn't work that way. So for business, it's not good. That's why you have some organization, they already tell you in advance, if you want to speak, you're not allowed to say the word punishment in the entire seminar. Yes, you have to commit. Why? We don't want people to run away. The next seminar, they won't come. We lose money. But our job is not to be a social organization, to do business, to entertain people, to eat some good chulent. Our job is to teach the Torah. If you teach the Torah, you have to teach it correctly. If you're not strong enough to teach the Torah correctly, don't teach at all. Better for you. Why would you dare to teach the opposite of what's written? So I give you an example. Based on this Gemara in Masechet Sanhedrin, it says that if a person dies in a sudden, strange way, he will take some of his sins off. Avel kapara, he has some kapara. It never ever says that he's holy, that he goes express to heaven, that he's never going to get punishment for his sins. Where does it say such thing? Everything you ever heard from all these liberals, it's all lies. There's no such thing. There's no source for it. I argue with many of them, and some of them admit it. You're right, there's no source. So why are you saying it? Because this is what everybody say. So what do we care what everyone say? A lot of Christians with their baloney say JC will come and save the world. Who cares what they say? We want source, not baloney. We don't want to bring a source from a book that is full of human error is in every page. You understand? Yeah.